Hello friends, welcome to Pioneer of Success. This video is a part of the miscellaneous series, and in this video we are not going to talk about any technical aspect of COMSOL simulation. Rather, we are going to talk about how to maintain COMSOL file size after your simulation. Maintaining COMSOL file size is very important because many times we run a lot of simulations and that actually enhances the disk, actually captures a lot of disk space on our computers, and hence it is necessary to have a good bookkeeping, and hence I hope this video will be helpful for researchers. Before I start today's video, I would like to make an announcement. Most of the times you people write to me with your queries and I generally reply you back within a week or so, and sometimes I skip the emails. And if I do so, do not hesitate to write me back, actually ping me so that I can again see your email and I can reply back to you. And very recently we have started a task where you can actually request us for a video call, and we would like to interact with you so that we can try to help you out for developing your problem. If you would like to talk to us on video call, please write to me in the email ID that is given in the description box. And one more thing. Now we expect a small contribution from you if we are helping for your COMSOL simulation via video calling. Writing me or commenting on the comment box, you can anytime do. But if you are expecting a video call, then we would expect a small contribution amount, because that will help us to sustain our work, to continue with our work. So with this, I stop here and continue with today's discussion. So today's discussion, as I have mentioned, is about maintaining file size. So this is a simulation which I have taken from application library, and we have already talked about this particular simulation. So this is about the jet instability. Let me show you the simulation result so that you can actually visualize this, because we have already done it. So this is a simulation where they have actually solved for the Marangoni force driven thread of liquid is ruptured into droplets. And in this particular case, if you see, we have solved for the two-phase flow, and this is a time-dependent solution, and the range of time steps is we have solved for up to 2e to the power minus 5 second with an interval of 2e to the power minus 7. So if you go to any of the results, then you see we have actually this many intermediate steps. So what does that intermediate steps means? It basically means at all the intermediate steps, it has stored the data so that we can visualize for the velocity field, pressure field, volume fraction field, and any other possible field that is there in COMSOL. So what exactly is happening? If you increase the step amounts, the number of steps, then what will happen? COMSOL has to save more and more data, and saving more and more data will increase the file size automatically. So you carefully choose this number of steps. If you do not need this many steps, then do not go ahead with this many steps. Reduce the number of steps. This is one of the thing. And the other thing is number of meshes. You all know, as we increase the number of mesh size, then more and more data has to be captured for the same simulation. But you cannot compromise with the mesh size, because this is important. If you have a fine mesh, then you have more accurate solution. So I don't prefer to compromise with number of meshes, but you have to compromise with number of meshes sometimes if your simulations are not getting converged. It is taking a lot of time, which is beyond the physical reliability. So in those cases, we have to compromise with the mesh size itself. But the ultimate idea is, the more data we make COMSOL save to it, it would actually enhance the file size. So If you maintain those things, then your file size will be minimum and you can save more amount of files. And if I talk about sometimes what happens, we run similar kind of simulations and most of the simulations we don't need actually to look at, but the thing what we have what model we have done is sometimes become important, because maybe we'll be working on some other field and we'll forget about this, and that's why keeping these files become important. So in those cases, what you can do is you can actually erase the solution and save the file. So there is a simple methodology where you can actually erase the solution. If you go to study, you can see there is an option of clear solution and another option is clear all solutions. So if I just want to keep the model, don't need the study, then I can click here and it will clear all the solutions. So if you see, after it works, so it will, if I go back, see there is no more solution coming. So once I do it, it will drastically reduce the file size, but you can see I have not missed any information in terms of the modeling. I have all the variables already intact. I have all the parameters which are there in the simulation. I have materials, laminar flow, everything is intact. And then you have to just save the file and you can store it. So this is how you can keep your old files without the solution. And then if anytime in future, if you need it, you can again open your file and you can run the simulation to regenerate the data. So I hope this video was helpful. If this is so, I would request you to subscribe to my channel for more videos.